Hello world, and welcome to Coding After Effects Back to Basics. In this tutorial, I want to talk about using the external text editor for expression. And one of the reasons you want to use this external text editor is because if you ever use the expression text editor in After Effects, you can kind of feel how basic it is. It doesn't really have too many extra functionalities in there to help you out. And from me coming from the programming world, I can tell you that there are a lot of other text editors that's out there that feels a lot better. It has a lot more functionality. It can help you out with coding a lot of stuff. And I also want to go over some of the weaknesses of using the expression editor before I actually go into using an external text editor. And when I talk about the expression editor, of course I'm talking about this little area right here where you use text to change the property of a layer. So one of the big problems I have with using the expression editor is it doesn't number its lines. So that means if I make an error or a mistake, usually it'll show up here and it'll tell you what line that is messing up at, but you will have to count down to see which line that is messing up at. And I can show you in this code right here. So if I just scroll down and make an error somewhere, let's say I get rid of this and just put X. It says that in the ninth line, there's a error going on. So if I come back in here, that means I have to count from this very first line all the way down to the ninth one. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this can be a problem if you have a huge amount of code and there's like hundreds and hundreds of lines you have to go through to just find what line that the error is located at. And another thing that I don't really too much care for, that there's no auto completion in here. So if I was to type in anything, it doesn't help me quickly write something. The closest thing you have to a auto completion is this little thing right here, but even that means I have to go to this arrow and scroll through here just to pick out an auto completion for me, and that's a little bit too much work. The next thing I don't care about is just how much real estate this takes up and how much I have to change just to have a comfortable workspace. So if I wanted to see more of this, as you can see, this is already taking up a big chunk of my timeline window. I have to scroll this down. And if I have hundreds and hundreds of layers, I mean, I have to scroll this up if I don't want to see this anymore. And this is a lot of up and down, just trying to make this comfortable for me to work in. And I don't want to do all that work. And there's plenty of other things that I just don't like about the expression editor. And I can kind of go on for days and things I just don't like about using in here. But I'm going to save some of that for later. I want to go over like what other text editors you can use. Any text editor you want. You can use text editor for Mac. You can use Notepad for Windows. You can also use Microsoft Word if you wanted to. But I would prefer if you use a text editor that was actually made for coding. A few of them that I would probably recommend you use is Notepad++, Atoms, Brackets, or you use Visual Studio Basics. The last four programs that I name off are well known and is available for free. So you can try any of them out and don't have to worry about ads or have to pay anything for them. And they are all really good programs too. But for this tutorial, I will be using Brackets. And the reason why I'm going to be using Brackets is because it's an Adobe product. And why not use an Adobe product with another Adobe product? And if you want to download it, you can go to brackets.io. And I will leave a link in the description if you just want to try it out. See, what we have here on the right is we have Brackets. And in here, the first thing you want to do is you want to create a file. And I'm going to go over here and right click and click on new file and write in expression.js. push enter. And the reason why you want to use the .js extension is because JS stands for JavaScript. In a text editor that uses JS enter, you want to use JS to get some of the benefits that they use for JavaScript, like the color-coded text and maybe even the plugins that they use for JavaScript, so we can benefit from it since they're so similar in the language. So in here, I'm going to type in var, and you can see as soon as I start typing, there's an auto-completion box over here that if I was to come over here and click in var, it gives me var. And in here, I'm going to put str for string. I'm going to have it equal to After Effects. And you see, once I typed in the double quotes, it automatically put my cursor inside of the quotes, and it gave me two quotes in there. That's another benefit of using the text editor. It do more auto completion and help you out a lot with writing it in code for you, so you don't make little small mistakes. So at the bottom, with the second line, I'm going to push type in str, and it gave me an auto completion for that too. With this, I'm just going to save. I'm going to keep the code a little bit simple, and the error thing should have popped up automatically, but if I go down here and click on it, it's going to show me where it believe I have errors in my code. And right now, most of it is basically saying I don't have any semicolons at the end. So if I put a semicolon at the end of each line and I push Control S again to save, you can see that both of those errors went away. It's still giving me one error just because it's reading this file as a JavaScript file. So we'll call an expression or a variable by itself at any time without any other changes to it. It's not good code in JavaScript, but for expression, this is fine. So we're always going to get this error. I want to take this file and let After Effects read it so we can run this code. So the first thing I want to do is I want to get where this code is located by right-clicking on the file and going to Show in Explorer. And right now, the Explorer already has this file selected. So what I want to do is I want to go to Copy Path, minimize that. And then last line, I want to push Control V to paste it. And I want to go to Find, Replace. And right here, I want to get rid of the backslashes and put double backslashes. So I'm going to type backslash and replace with double backslash. And you can't see it, but it's supposed to be a replace all option right here. So to find it, I'm just going to get rid of this little bar right here so we don't need it anymore. And click on replace all. And the reason why we need to do this is because a single backslash by itself cancels out the quotes in our string. So if I was to try to use this, once it gets to user, it won't count as a string anymore. So using a double backslash makes sure that our string stays a string. So I'm going to copy this. So I'm going to go into After Effects. But before I do that, let me get rid of this last line right here and save it again. And I'm going to go to source text in my text layer, alt click on source text, and type in var path for the name of the variable, and I'm going to paste in what I had in the text editor. In my next line, I'm going to type in $.eval file. And in parentheses, I'm going to type in path. And if I push enter on a number pad, you see we get After Effect. It's running our code. It's basically looking in here and saying, create a variable called str and assigned it After Effects. And then in the second line, I want you to return this variable. And since it's returning it, it's giving us After Effects. And that's basically it. We executed our code that we had in our external text editor. But there's one issue you might come across. If I was to try to change this, instead of this being After Effects, this being Change Me, and I save it, You can see After Effects didn't update itself. It still says After Effects for our text. To update itself, all I need to do is go to this equal sign over here, click on it once, and click on it again, and it now updates itself. So that's basically it for using an external text editor. For a small code like this, it's not really necessary to use a text editor. You probably want to start using the text editor once you start getting about 10 lines long or more, or if you have a big project that uses a lot of similar code in it for different layers, you might want to use an external text editor. And I will go into more details of how to do so and what other conveniences that this text editor uses. But for right now, you can go download brackets, see how it works, or any other text editor you want to try out. I really recommend doing this. And I hope you learned something. And if you enjoyed this video, check out my older videos. Until the next time, peace out, world.